wanted to update you on the cart. I'm scheduled to get my inspection done this Tuesday. I have every reason to believe it'll pass based on my pre-inspection with the same health inspector. Want to have you take a look at my banners here that I had made for the hot dog cart, my logo here. The idea was to make it as eye-catching as possible, and I thought, like you suggested many times, black and red against yellow or something bright like that. And I think it's proven to work. I mean, it just seems to pop pretty well. We're just going to kind of pan around the cart here, kind of give you an overview of how I expect it to look when I start bending here. I decided to mount this menu up here so people wouldn't feel committed to buy. They could see the menu before they actually decided to order, if they decided they wanted to order anything. And I built this on a hinge, so it goes down like this. I still have to rig something to have it stand up on its own, which is why this box is here. And then right here, I plan to put chips, sort of thing. My bread box right here. And again, I have a menu that I mounted on hinges to make it easier for folks to read what I offer and place their order here. As per the health department, the entire prep area had to be enclosed. We'll get back there in just a minute, but I want to pan out and show you my other banner here to kind of get your opinion on this. I went ahead and used PVC pipe, went ahead and primed it, painted it red. I thought it looked pretty good against the yellow banner. And you can kind of see for yourself, got my solar panel mounted up there, and I've been having major electrical problems. I think I've got everything ironed out. There, got my speakers. The theme of my hot dog cart will be Detroit Coney Dogs. So I mounted the stereo speaker system in order to be able to play classic Motown tunes while people enjoy their hot dogs. Continuing around, we've got, as per the health department regulation again, 3-compartmental sink. Yeah, pretty much self-explanatory here. Down here underneath the sink, I've got the my stereo, and I've got the wastewater pump, and then back in here, which is kind of hard to see because it's so dark, I've got the freshwater pump. Just makes it a whole lot easier all the way around to turn on the pump, and then I just basically point this to where I want to expel the water, and there you go. So there's that. Telling you about, I was so proud of the pre-inspection, I didn't think I'd have to build this, but I didn't want to fight with it, so another $500 later, I went ahead and built this enclosure, and I think it turned out pretty well. Plenty of room to lay my supplies here, and here's a little feature that I kind of incorporated into the serving area, but this area right here, I've got a lever here, I press that down, and I'm able to serve the product through here while being able to speak to the customer through the screen. Rather, lift it back up, and then down below here is my bread box area, and got my 3 full-size steam pan firebox here, 6 burners, which I purchased from you. I'm very happy with them. And then down below here is access into the firebox itself. You can see the vents that I've put in the bottom here. Everything works pretty well. I've got an emergency shutoff gas valve that I incorporated into here. Let's see. Moving right along, I went ahead and built a sliding cooler to keep condiments, hot dogs, and so forth. I thought it would be more convenient to keep them in here than my refrigerator area. But anyway, I think this works out pretty well. It's convenient, easy to get to. Slides right in out of sight. And I Moving to the refrigerator. I've got a Frigidaire 7 cubic foot refrigerator here. And as you can tell, it needs to be cleaned. I bought it used, but it works well. No problems at all. Inspector loved it. It's commercial grade. And I've got it on a slider to be able to slide in and out, to be able to service it when I need to. So that's that. I've got another menu right here. Just to give another perspective to folks who weren't ready to committed to buy my product, here's the sink. As per the health inspector requirements, it's got to be dedicated to hand washing, my soap dispenser required. And here's my solar panel. And then, of course, my paper towel mount. And, just continuing around here. Kind of something I incorporated. I looked at some videos. Come on over here, babe. Right here, I'm able to drain water because it gets a little colder in California. It doesn't get that cold, but occasionally it does get cold, so I want to be able to drain water out of the water system. And I'm able to do that through these valves here. Secondly, this valve is meant to recycle regular water in through the heater, but it doesn't drain into the drain. It just recycles clean water into the heater, so I don't waste as much water waiting for it to come up to temperature. And it works really well, really happy with it. I can detail that for you if you'd be interested in knowing about it. My water heater that I bought from you works great. Love it. And I'm going to go ahead and remove this banner. And by the way, these are PVC caps that I went ahead and drilled a hole, filled it with epoxy, and put a screw in there, reinforced it around the edge so it's really strong. And my banners just slide onto here. I've got four mount points. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then same with the front of the cart that we showed you earlier. Anyway, here's my propane tank compartment. All this was done by hand. Kind of had to learn everything, but this is what I came up with, and everything works great. I've got a separate valve for each tank just as a precautionary measure. Dual tank setup. And I've got vents in here, of course, and everything is really sturdy, and really happy with the way that turned out. This door offers access into the cart to be able to get to various electrical and gas and water components, drain system here and so forth, as well as my junction box for the solar panel. Wires come out from the inverter into this junction box and then out of the inverter, out through an exit point that I built into the cart that attaches to the solar panel. So there we have that. And now the heart of the system is right here. Works great. I think I have all the kinks worked out. Basically, I've got my 3,000 watt inverter here. And here's the refrigerator plug to power it. I've got three 12-volt, 92-amp-hour batteries, so I've got more than enough power even without the solar panel. Solar panel just helps the batteries discharge at a slower rate. Even though the inverter has a AC charger and a solar charger built into the system, I went ahead and purchased this external battery charger, and I feel more confident to the way it charges the batteries. It actually conditions the batteries as it charges them, so that's basically it. I also put an on and off switch here to be able to feed power to this four outlet receptacle. And it works really well as well, especially when I decide to vent at night, whenever that may be, and I can plug LED lights or whatever I need to into that system. Last compartment is on the side here. And this allows me better access to the fresh water pump. that I couldn't really show you before. And here's a drainage system for the three compartment sink, vents, stereo, etc., etc. And yep, it was a labor of love, but I had a heck of a fun time building it, as I've told you before. And I'm very much looking forward to bending. I'm feeling pretty nervous, but at the same time, I'm feeling extremely energized. And
that's the best part.
Looking forward to donning my hot dog hat here. So, Ben, I just wanted to share this video with you, and I want you to feel free to share it with fellow hot doggers. I'd like to be able to be an encouragement to anybody that's thinking about getting into the business. If I can do it, anybody can with your help. There you go, Ben. Thanks again, man. Be talking to you soon.